Hello, this is Roland. Today I want to talk about meditation, a very special meditation that I have, which is special because it does the right thing. And the right thing is to get you out of being lost in your thoughts, which cater to your ego. See, when you're lost in thoughts, you're very subjective. Concerned about yourself, thinking about me, I. Worried about me, worried about that, this and that. Resenting having made mistakes. Okay? Worrying about, first of all, it's faithless. When you're lost down in your thinking, first of all, there are no answers down there, but there you are anyway. And it's faithless. See, worry is faithless. And secondly, it's selfish. Okay, but this is not a put down, because we're all born selfish. We're naturally selfish. Okay, that's the way we are. That's the fallen human condition. Okay, now what you need is to get out of your thinking and get a little bit of perspective. Get a little bit of distance from your thoughts instead of drowning in your thinking, submerged in thinking. Thoughts that fascinate. See, they fascinate you, don't they? All the negative thoughts. What if this? What if that? See, even the negative thoughts that, you know, like I'm no good, nothing ever works out for me, I'm unlucky, blah, 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 blah. See, they fascinate the ego. It's basically temptation. That's how it was in the Garden of Eden, remember? The serpent approached Eve, talked to Eve, and Eve approached Adam and said what the serpent had said. See? And then he started to think about, you know, well, did God really say this and that and so on and so forth? That's how doubt entered. Okay, so now we're doubters. We're compulsive doubters. You need faith. But you don't have faith. Okay, we're compulsive worriers. You need faith. You don't have faith. See, what you need is truth. What you need is truth, and that is to just simply see the way things are from, well, I don't want to say God's perspective, but almost. Maybe from His perspective. See, now, for example, let's take something that you, somehow where you messed up. You look at it egotistically, subjectively. You blame yourself. See, blame. You blame someone else, or you blame yourself, or you blame God. Okay? You roll up your sleeves and try to fix it, to save face and look good in somebody else's eyes or in your own eyes. Make things worse. Okay, so your good actions are not for the purpose of doing good. The pure, you know, Christ said, "Let not your left hand know what your right hand is doing." See, good flows forth naturally. It flows forth without thinking, without premeditation, spontaneously. There it is. And so, what you need is the truth. That's all you need is truth. The truth with a capital T, in other words, to see things in the light of truth. You see yourself worrying, doubting, struggling. Okay, you'll just see that. Okay, well, that's a big truth. Or maybe the first truth you see is that you're resentful. Okay, well, that's a big thing to see. If you can see that, if you can see that you're resentful, or see that you're struggling, trying to save yourself, for example, trying to look good, trying to prove something, putting on a show for someone or for God, or see, if you see that, well, that's already truth. In other words, let's suppose there's a math problem. Okay, student can't get solved math problem, but the professor says, oh, there's the error right there. The student looks and looks and looks, finally, oh, I see. Okay, that's all that is needed. That's enough, right there. That's enough. So if you see that you're resentful without resenting yourself, okay, here's a secret. Can you see that you're resentful without resenting seeing it. See, most people resent seeing it. They actually are resenting the light. So if you can see that you are resentful without resenting the light showing you, rubbing your nose in it, that's a big step. Some people never get that to that point. Okay? And suppose you are resenting it. So you're resenting seeing something or other. There's something you don't want to see or admit about yourself. Well, okay, so then you just go about your business, go about your life, meditate if you can a little bit, just enough to get some light into your life. See, some objectivity, and then eventually one day you see that you're resentful, that you resent seeing it, or that you resent God, okay? You know, that a lot of people do, you know. See, God doesn't hate you back. He wants you to see it, because then you can stop resenting God. You see what I mean? See how that is? So you have a good dad, and dad says something, and then you don't admit to dad that you messed up. You didn't do what he said. So you don't want to admit it, but then finally one day, hey, dad, I'm sorry I did what you said. He said, okay, you know, I knew that you had, and I'm just waiting for you to be sorry. Admit it, that's all. So just admit it. David says that in one of the Psalms. Maybe it's Psalm 36, I'm not sure. But he said, I uncovered my sins, okay, and you forgave them. See? So you have to uncover them to God. How do you do that? Well, what you do is you meditate a little bit, which means that you're willing to see in God's light, and then wait for the things to be revealed and exposed, seen, and just don't resent. Whatever comes, just see it. That's all you have to do is stand back and observe it. You don't have to do anything about it. Okay? Don't try to change yourself. Don't try to save yourself. Okay? Now, a little bit of light is better than no light. A little bit of truth, see? A little bit of objectivity is better than no objectivity. So if you have a little bit, that's good. Then pray for more. See, pray for more objectivity, standing back and observing things. Okay? It's very, very important. That's what meditation helps you do. Now, so, just see what is. Okay? Don't struggle with the voices, the thoughts, the doubts. Don't struggle with any of them. And then when your thoughts will try to trick you too, they'll say, "Oh, first of all, they might say, you know, you're messing up. You're no good. Meditation is not going to work for you. You're too far gone. Blah blah blah." It's just they're just tempting you. That's all. It's just tease. Just watch it. Let it pass. And then when the thoughts come, say, "Oh, now you're doing really well. Now you're a holy person and you're above meditation. You don't need it anymore." And, you know, more tease. Just observe all those thoughts, those silly thoughts. Okay? Those thoughts. Observe them. They don't like to be observed. See? Then eventually you'll see that they're just empty, useless thoughts. You'd be surprised. They're not even your thoughts. Don't ask yourself a question and get an answer. The answer comes back as it down there answering those thoughts, wherever they come from. They tell you what you want to hear. See? If you have some objectivity, then now you know you can tell a bad thought. Maybe you can't. Some of them are very subtle, but you can tell a bad thought. So next time, if you become resentful towards somebody, a neighbor, something, then all of a sudden you'll hear. In your mind there will be thoughts, mean thoughts, nasty thoughts, thinking of terrible things to say to that about that person, and you'll see those thoughts and you'll suddenly realize, what's that? I don't really want to think that. Or is that really true? See, that's another thing. The thoughts will say, blah blah blah. Is that really true? No, it's just a thought. Okay? So that's very, very important. So a little bit of objectivity. So that's what meditation will help you do. So how do you get started? Very simple. I have several. There's a 5-minute meditation, which is excellent. My classic meditation, they have a little bit of a spiritual touch to them, which is nice. I like that, okay? The easy meditation that I have, or the prayer meditation, is very simple. You just sit down. get up in the morning, drag yourself to the bathroom, put the toilet lid down, sit on the toilet lid for 5 minutes, okay, and close your eyes and just look at the inside of your eyelids. See the little pixels of light, the little patterns of light, little sparkly light, warm glow. See? Just watch it. And you'll probably notice that the first thing in the morning, your thoughts are very strong. You'll notice that you're looking at the inside of your eyelids, and then all of a sudden you'll be thoughts of what you're going to do, planning to do during the day, and so on. See how those, see? Well, then you just redirect your attention to the inside of your eyelids and look at the little bit of light on the inside of your eyelids, okay? And then at the same time, become aware of your hands. Your hand, right hand may be hanging by your side, or your hands in your lap, just in your lap, however you want, fingertip to fingertip, or just in your lap. Just become aware of your hands while you're looking at the inside of your eyelids until you feel a little warmth, a little tingly in your hands. Noticing your hands, you'll feel a little something in them, okay? Then go out, just go out about your life. Don't try to be a holy person. Don't expect anything. See, expectation ruins it. It's what you're planning to have. It's what your ego wants, maybe, okay? So no, you're not going to walk on water, and you're not going to solve all the world's problems, and you're not, see, it's just, you're just going to go out and be a regular person. But now, with a little bit of objectivity, how much, I don't know, but you'll have some, a little bit, maybe, or a lot, but you'll have some. Now, all of a sudden, you'll notice something. You'll see the meaning of it, wordlessly. You'll notice something about yourself or about someone else, and you'll just see what the meaning of the moment is. Okay. All right. And the other thing is, as you go about your day, once in a while, you can close your eyes, look at the inside of your eyelids for a little while if you can, or you can, as you're out in the world, once in a while, you can direct your attention to your hands. For example, this morning I went for a walk. Went to do a little bit of reading, a little bit of, you know, realizing, and a little bit of reading, and then I went for my walk, and as I was walking, probably lost in thinking, I snapped out of it, and then I became aware of my hands as I was walking. Aware of my hands, so they were kind of warm, I noticed my hands, okay? So you can use that. Noticing your hands is also a way of coming back to the present. Okay? So you can use that as you're doing things. You know, as you're going about your business. Once in a while, just notice. Once in a while, just notice. Or if you're lost in thinking, then snap out of it. You're lost in a daydream, snap out of it. You're lost in reliving the past, snap out of it. You're worried about something, see that you are, and snap out of it. That's all. So life from now on will be a process of endlessly snapping out a million times, a million, million times. Okay? But you'll see the present, but the light is there helping you to snap out. And then you'll have little insights. Okay? So now you've accomplished a couple of very nice things with the help of meditation. You're snapping out of being lost in thinking, lost in those thoughts that deceive you and fool you and trick you, and lead to emotions and making the wrong move. Okay. How many times have you pre-planned what you were going to say to somebody, and you go and you pre-plan this clever thing, and then you say it, and it's all wrong? See? Now, if you mess up, and you feel a little bad, if you realize that you messed up, you feel bad about it, then just feel bad about it. Regret. See, regret the way you are. If you can't, if you don't regret, see, the way you are, then you don't. See that also. Don't worry about it. Just go about your business. Go to work. Okay? Go to school. Study. Help somebody. Do whatever your life is. Just go and do it. And, if once in a while you see something about yourself, you hated your mom, or you're phony with your wife, or you mean to somebody, then see it. And if you do feel bad about it, then just feel that quietly within a little bit, and then it'll be over. Okay, that's all. See, that's the light. The light is there showing you. But don't try to make anything happen. See, some people, then the other thing is that some people come from a faith tradition, like they come from a, oh, I don't know. Well, it could be anything. It could be Pentecostal, or it could be Greek Orthodox, or Catholic, or it could be anything. That has some kind of a, how can I say, the meditative prayer, what do you call it, contemplative prayer, you know, those sorts of things. And so they have some idea of what that should be and what a holy person is, you know, walking around with robes, robes on and big old cross hanging. Here, have you ever seen? There was some religious phony on that was I forget who it was, but he had a big old cross on. But anyway, they have some idea of what a holy person should be, you know. And having that idea, they just